motivating people to change can be a difficult task. Ercilia Serafini knows about that struggle. Part of her job is to convince people to buy into a particular conversation. And she joins us now to explain how. Here is Ercilia Serafini. She is the president of the Summerhill Group, and we welcome you here to TVO.
Thank you so much.
Okay, you heard all about this, the IPCC report, 195 member countries and 700 plus authors and almost 1,800 expert reviewers. What did you think of the report?
My eyes glazed over. That's what I thought of the report. And I only attempted to read the summary for policymakers.
And your eyes glazed over because, on the biggest issue of our time, your eyes glazed over because?
Because I actually believe, through the work that we do, that people know that there's a serious crisis facing our climate, that they know that there's action to be taken. And I also think that there's a bit of message fatigue, right? It's very doom and gloom and dreading the future outcome. And I think people are much more motivated by a positive, optimistic message.
So you can only tell them we're going to hell in a handcart so many times.
Absolutely.
Before they start to tune out?
Tune out. Eyes glaze over.
And is that your sense of this debate, is that people have started to tune out?
I think that's certainly part of it. I think the work that Summerhill does is talk to individuals, tenants, employees, in their place of work, in their communities. People are motivated to take action. This next generation, you know, over the last 10 years, they know that they should be recycling. They know that we should be more energy efficient. So that's actually not the issue, from my perspective.
Well, hang on. They know, but do they do?
They do.
They do.
They do in spades. We run some of the biggest conservation programs on behalf of electric and gas utilities. And when you get the message right and you get that right combination of reward, motivating behavior, you make it easy and convenient, you have a call to action. You know, we have people collect 500,000 free light bulbs over a weekend. 168,000 people over 18 months turn in their old vehicle. So we can get people to take those actions.
Your group organizes this kind of stuff?
Yes, that's the kind of work that Summerhill does.
Did you say 500,000 light bulbs?
500,000 light bulbs over 6 days.
How do you do that?
Well, we make it easy for people. So where do people purchase light bulbs? At retail. Mm-hmm. A lot of our campaigns are actually executed where it's the easiest for people to make that decision. So if it's the Home Depot, if it's Costco, if it's Lowe's, if it's Canadian Tire, we'll send our people to the point at which you're making that important and critical purchasing decision.
So if you purchase a new CFL light bulb, you hit them up at that point saying, give us the old, you know, mercury-filled ones or whatever they call. What do they call the old ones? I forget now.
The incandescents.
Incandescents.
But now we're on to LEDs. You know, we're on to the new technology
shift. We've moved on. Okay. Well, who are your clients?
So our clients are the, you know, leading electric and gas utilities in the country. Yeah.
And you've approached them, or they approach you, or how does it work?
So it's a combination of the two. I mean, energy is a provincial issue, so it depends which province you're in. But there's a realization that the cheapest form of supply is conservation.
Of course,
right?
Yeah.
So the cheapest kilowatt hour is the one that's not produced. So there's a real impetus on behalf, I think, of our governments and, you know, some of our leading corporate citizens to bring those choices to their customers.
Here's one of the arguments, though, I've always had a tough time with, I have to confess, and that is that if you get an energy producer, let's say Ontario Power Generation, for lack of a better example, and they claim to be in the conservation business, they claim to be telling people, I shouldn't say they claim, they are telling people, use less electricity,
absolutely,
use less power. But of course, their debt is massive, and if they're ever going to pay that off, they actually need us to use twice as much power as we're using right now so that we'll buy it at the high rates that we pay so they can pay off their massive debts. Do they have a problem with a mixed message?
There is a problem with the mixed message. But the leading message, and we've seen it over the last few months in particular, the rising cost of energy. And the one message, the only one that resonates with the homeowner and the person getting that bill, is that my costs are going up and up and up. And so there's a big customer service issue here, right? Because if the only relationship you have with me is that I'm handing you my money every month and it's just going up, that is not a great place to be. That is not a great place to be.
So you think they actually, and I know they're mandated by the Ontario government to make the pitch for conservation, I get that. But you think they're the wrong actor in some respects to be delivering that message? Am I hearing that right?
No, I think they are. They are the right actor.
They are the right person to do.
Because the relationship as a customer with my energy and electricity is with the person that's providing it. So if Toronto Hydro is providing the electricity, if Enbridge Gas is sending me that bill, then my strongest relationship as a credible voice on the issue of conservation is going to come from that company. It's not going to come from somebody else. I want to know from them, what are you going to do to help me lower the cost of my bill every month?
But we need you to do that, don't we?
We do it on their behalf.
You do it on their behalf.
We do it on their behalf because, you know, if you go to somebody's door, you show up in a store, people are going to say to me, well, what's your interest in this, right? Hmm. The natural inclination is, who are you to tell me what to do?
Can you tell me this? I have heard the Minister of Energy stand up in the legislature frequently and off a piece of paper, start reading out the price per kilowatt hour that we pay for electricity in the province of Ontario. Or actually, he goes by city. In Ottawa, we're paying this. In Toronto, we're paying this. In Hamilton, we're paying this. And then he lists a lot of other cities and other provinces and in other states in the United States.
Yeah.
And on that list, we seem to be paying less than a lot of other big jurisdictions.
We are.
Is that true?
Absolutely, it's true.
So
the
how come all we ever hear?
Is quite significantly lower than other jurisdictions.
Okay, because all I ever hear from anybody else is that we're paying way too much for price per kilowatt hour because of all of the green energy that we've brought onto the grid in the last 5 years.
I think there's a lot of misinformation. I also think it's easy for media and other channels to pick up on a simple message. We know that simple messages resonate with individuals. And so it's very easy, I think, to capitalize on one thing and attribute the source of you know, rising energy to one specific thing. The reality is, in the province of Ontario, our energy system is so complex. The issue of climate change is so complex, and that complexity is what leads to challenge in figuring out how to actually engage with people on what solutions are. It's way too complex to answer in 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but in that case, beyond the obvious, we all want to pay less for electricity. Beyond the obvious, we care, you know, polls will agree to a lesser or more extent on what to do about climate change. How do you go about convincing people in their day-to-day behavior that they've got to change what they do so that the planet doesn't burn up around us?
So there's a few things that are pretty key from a behavioral economic standpoint. You know, one is that motivation, that reward incentive. We see that it works. A reward incentive paired with a call to action, some sense of urgency.
For example, this is
going to run out.
For example,
$5 off this LED light bulb this weekend only. Come in and get it before they're gone because you're never going to pay less than that.
That works?
Though that is hugely motivating, and we've seen tremendous success when you pair that call to action. If you return your window air conditioner this weekend to this spot, we'll give you $25. That can be tremendously motivating. And we see, you know, we saw tens of thousands of Torontonians take action in similar campaigns. So we know how to get individuals to take action. I think the big challenge we have with an issue like climate change or our energy systems is it's more than just changing your light bulb or returning a window air conditioner. And as individuals, we know what we can do. We also want to know what it is our corporate citizens are doing and what our governments are doing to lead us down that path to a new economy.
How about this one? Remember, I think it was several years ago, the Ontario government said, bring us your old energy hogging refrigerators and you know, go buy a new one and we'll, I don't know, give you some kind of rebate or something like that. Did that work?
Absolutely, it worked.
It did work, eh?
And it works in every jurisdiction we run those programs in. People are willing to take action. You know, I think there is an enormous amount of messaging that's going on. And I said it at the beginning. People know that there are things that we can do, and they're willing to do them if you make it really, really easy. I look at the next generation. I look at my kids. I'm doing an Earth Day presentation next week at their school. 7 years old, what do you want me to talk about? Oh, talk about recycling. Talk about saving energy. You know, we know at our base what we can control. The question is, what is the next step? And I really think that in a mobile world, in a world where we're so connected, that thinking about how we use data, thinking about how we allow people greater control through the use of their mobile phones or their iPads or their laptops is going to take us that step change in terms of next level engagement on issues that are critical to this time, like climate change and energy.
Okay. Ursulia, thanks so much for coming in tonight.
Thank you.
That's Ursulia Serafini, president of the Summerhill Group.
Support Ontario's public television. Donate at tvo.org.